Good morning, students. Today, let us start the lesson Vijayanagara Kingdom. Vijayanagara Kingdom is one of the most famous and popular kingdom of South India. In this chapter, we are going to learn about establishment of Vijayanagara Empire, the achievements of Vijayanagara kings, the administration, social and economic condition of Vijayanagara period, art and architecture during the time of Vijayanagara period, and the religious equality maintained by Vijayanagara kings. The establishment of Vijayanagara Empire is landmark in Indian history. Why? Because the expedition which started during the 13th century by Delhi Sultan Alauddin Khilji over South India continued in 14th century also. As a result, the South Indian dynasties like the Yadavas of Devagiri, the Kakatiyas of Warangal, the Pandyas of Madurai, Hoysalas of Dwarasamudra, the Cholas of Tanjavuru were all the victims of violent attacks of Alauddin Khilji. Means, when the Vijayanagara kingdom was established in South India, during that time in North India, Delhi Sultans were the rulers. So, Alauddin Khilji frequently used to attack these dynasties and they were all the victims of violent attacks of Alauddin Khilji. As a result, political instability, lawlessness, fear and religious turmoil prevailed everywhere. Under these circumstances, the kingdom of Vijayanagara was born in South India. This empire ruled for 3 centuries, means 300 years Vijayanagara Empire ruled South India. By 15th century, it spread up to Indian Ocean in the south, Bay of Bengal in east, and Arabian Sea in the west. Now, let us see who were the founders of Vijayanagara Empire, when it was established. Hakka and Bukka established this empire on the bank of the river Tungabhadra in the year 1336 CE. Vijayanagara Empire was established by Hakka and Bukka. It was established on the bank of the river Tungabhadra. In which year it was established? It was established in the year 1336 CE. They made Hampi as their capital. At present, Hampi is in Bellary district. The Vijayanagara kingdom had to face the resistance of the following kingdoms that were present during this time: Delhi Sultans, Gajapatis of Orissa, and Bahmani kings of Northern Deccan. With these difficulty, Vijayanagara Empire came into the existence. Vijayanagara Empire was ruled by 4 dynasties, that is Sangama dynasty, Salva dynasty, Tuluva dynasty, and Aravidu dynasty. Now, let us see about Sangama dynasty. Sangama dynasty was ruled from 1336 CE to 1486 CE. The famous kings of Sangama dynasty were Arihara I, Bukkaraya, Arihara II, and Praudhadevaraya. During the time of Arihara, he expanded his territory. Now, let us see about Bukkaraya. Bukkaraya defeated the Reddys of Kondavidu and merged the Penukonda area with Vijayanagara. Bukka was successful in solving the religious war between the Jains and Sri Vaishnavas, thereby upheld the religious harmony. This shows that during the time of Bukkaraya, he had maintained a cordial relationship with other religions. This fact is revealed by one of the inscription in Shravana Belagola. He constructed a fort and few temples in the capital and encouraged agricultural activities during his time. Bukkaraya sent an ambassador to the court of Chinese king belonging to the Ming dynasty. This shows that he has cordial relationship with other foreign countries. Bukka's son Kampana defeated the Sultan of Madurai and enlarged his kingdom. This victory is marked in Madura Vijayam written by Ganga Devi. The achievement of Kampana was explained in the book which is called as Madura Vijayam, which was written by Ganga Devi. Now let us see about Arihara II. During the 27 years rule of Arihara, the son of Bukkaraya, Vijayanagar Empire comprised of vast areas. He took into his control Kondavidu, Kurnool and Nelluru forts. Most of the areas came under the control of Arihara II. At the time of the death of Bahmani Sultan Muzahid, Arihara II expanded his kingdom from Goa to the north of the Konkana coast. He occupied the fort of Pangala lying to the north of Krishna River in the year 1398 CE. Now, let us see the most famous king of Sangama dynasty, that is Devaraya II. He was also called as Prouda Devaraya. This Prouda Devaraya ruled Vijayanagara kingdom from 1424 to 1446 CE. He was the most famous king of Sangama dynasty. He had earned the title Elephant Hunter. Why he had earned the title Elephant Hunter? Because he defeated the King Gajapati Kapilendra of Orissa and captured the Kondavidu from him. By suppressing the regional leaders of the borders, he expanded the kingdom up to Krishna River in the northeast. Later, he defeated the Kerala ruler and received royalties from Kerala and Sri Lanka. It means by defeating the rulers of Kerala and Sri Lanka, these places came under the control of Devaraya II. So, almost all the parts of South India came under the control of Devaraya II. For that, he earned the title Dakshinapatada Chakravarti. Dakshinapatada Chakravarti means the Emperor of the South. Through these conquests, the Vijayanagar Empire extended from Sri Lanka to Gulbarga and Telangana to Malabar. So, according to the Nunes, the kings of Ceylon, Pulicket, Pegu, Tansuriam were paying royalties to Prouda Devaraya. So, these are all the places now came under the control of Devaraya II. Devaraya II chased the traditional foe. Traditional foe means traditional enemy, who is called Ahmad Shah of Bahmani, till Bijapur and occupied Mudagal and Bankapur. His commander Lakkana Dandesha took up a successful naval voyage. Here we can understand almost all the parts of South India came under the control of Devaraya II during his time. Devaraya II was tolerant towards other religions. He constructed mosque, Jaina and Vaishnava temple in his capital. This shows that he was religious, tolerant ruler of Vijayanagara period. Being a poet, he had in his court the Sanskrit scholar Dindima and the Kannada scholar Lakkana Dandesha. During his period, Veerashaiva tradition and literature saw a revival. After the death of Devaraya II in 1446 CE, weak kings came to the power and the rule of Sangama dynasty came to an end. So here you have to remember, Devaraya II was the most famous ruler of Sangama dynasty. He had earned the title Dakshinapatada Chakravarti and Elephant Hunter, and he was a religious tolerant. He has given importance for literature and religion during his time. Now let us see about the most famous ruler of Vijayanagar Empire. You all know about him, who is called as Krishnadevaraya. Krishnadevaraya ruled Vijayanagar Empire from 1509 to 1529 CE. Who is Krishnadevaraya? He was a son of Narasanayaka of Tuluva dynasty and his second wife Naghalambika. Krishnadevaraya was the most famous king among the rulers of the Vijayanagar Empire, as I already told you. During his rule, Vijayanagar Empire reached the pinnacle of glory, means he has contributed in all the field. It may be in the administration, art, architecture and literature. He was compared to the world famous rulers like Ashoka, Samudragupta and Harshavardhana. He ruled over 20 years in Vijayanagara Empire. When he came to the power, the kingdom was facing various complicated internal and external problems. It means Krishnadevaraya did not come to the power easily. He has to face internal and external problem. By facing these problems, he came to the power. Who are the enemies of Krishnadevaraya? The Europeans who had arrived through new sea routes were establishing the colonies. Then the Mughals of north were trying to expand their empire in the south. The five Shahi kingdoms of the Bahmani dynasty became powerful sultanates and plunged into wars against Krishnadevaraya. So, by defeating the Europeans, Mughals and the Shahi kingdom, he expanded his territory and established strong empire in South India. In addition to these, the kings of Ummattoru and Orissa were a constant source of threat in India. Now, the military achievements of Krishnadevaraya. As mentioned by Robert Sewell, Krishnadevaraya was an unparalleled warrior, shrewd commander and political expert. He won all the wars and expanded his empire in the south. This shows that he was very good ruler, good administrator, courage warrior. By the time Krishnadevaraya ascended the throne, the law and order situation of Vijayanagar Empire had worsened due to the internal rivalries. As I already told you, he did not come to the power easily. When he came to the power, the condition of Vijayanagara Empire was worsened. He faced that problem and came to the power. The reign between 1510 to 1521 CE are filled with the longer sieges, war and victories. He undertook 14 major wars during his time. These wars were waged against Bahmani, Adil Shahis of Bijapur, Nizam Shahis of Ahmednagar, Kutub Shahis of Golconda, Gajapati of Orissa and other chieftains. In 1509, Yusuf Adil Shahi organized a combined attack of Adil Shahi dynasty on Vijayanagar Empire. Adil Shahi of Vijapur died in this attack. During this time, Krishnadevaraya annexed the Dob region of Raichuru. Dob region means the fertile area which had in Raichuru. Krishnadevaraya liberated Muhammad Shah and made him the king of Bahmani kingdom. So, he earned the title Evana Rajya Pratisthapan Acharya. Evana Rajya Pratisthapan Acharya was a title which was given to the Krishnadevaraya because he liberated Muhammad Shah and made him the king of Bahmani kingdom. These was destroyed the power of his enemies. Then he undertook a war on Gangaraya, the chieftain of Umattooru. This part was made part of Srirangapatna. Among the wars waged by Krishnadevaraya, the war with Gajapati of Orissa is very important. This war took place from 1512 to 1518 CE. He captured Kondavidu, Vijayawada and Kondapalli. These were the parts of Gajapati Rudra Pratapa Devaraya kingdoms in the southern parts. Gajapati surrendered and got his daughter married to Krishna Devaraya. She was called Jagan Mohini. In the year 1520 CE, he captured the Rayachuru from Adil Shahis of Vijapur. A tough battle took place between Vijayanagara and Bijapur for Rayachuru. The Portuguese supported Vijayanagara. When Vijayanagara Empire was ruling South India, during that time Portuguese came India and Vijayanagara Empire and Portuguese maintained cordial relationship. Earlier, Krishnadevaraya had helped Portuguese to capture Goa. So this made Portuguese to establish their trading center in Goa. During his reign, Vijayanagara kingdom extended from river Godavari and Krishna in the north to Indian Ocean in the south, from Arabian Sea in the west to Bay of Bengal in the east. By seeing the map, you can understand the entire South India came under the control of Krishnadevaraya. Krishnadevaraya was not only a skilled warrior but also an able administrator. His Telugu work Amukta Malyada reveals the shrewdness he possessed in matters of state. He wrote the book which is called as Amukta Malyada in Telugu language. It explains about the shrewdness he possessed in the matters of state, and he provided irrigation facilities for the expansion of agriculture. This says he has given importance for agricultural activity during his period. With the friendship of Portuguese, he increased the foreign trade. He abolished tax on marriages. He was a great patron of art, literature and religions. There were 8 Telugu poets who are known as Ashtadiggajas in his court. Ashtadiggajas were ruled. You may be knowing about the Tenali Ramakrishna. He was lived in the court of Krishnadevaraya during the time of Vijayanagar Empire. Krishnadevaraya was a poet himself and wrote a play which is called as Jambavati Kalyana in Sanskrit. You have to remember the two important works which were written by Krishnadevaraya, that is Jambavati Kalyana in Sanskrit and Amukta Malyada in Telugu language. Allasani Peddanna, Nandi Timmanna, Durjati, Tenali Ramakrishna and others were the Telugu poets who lived in the court of Krishnadevaraya.